Welcome to EPG Pathshala on the subject Social Medicine in Community Health. I am Professor Sriti Mishra, attached to Banaras Hindu University in the Department of Community Medicine, and I shall be discussing the module Sustainable Development Goals. This module belongs to the paper Healthcare Delivery System. This module has been developed by a team comprising of myself, Professor Devendra Kumar Taneja, and Dr. J. Tandon is the content reviewer. The learning objective that has been set for this module, that after going through this session, one should be able to define SDGs, that is Sustainable Developmental Goals, should be able to specify lessons learned from MDGs, to differentiate between MDGs and that is Millennium Developmental Goals and Sustainable Developmental Goals, and be able to enumerate goals of SDGs and pinpoint measure areas covered under the SDGs. After discussing the stating various learning objectives that has been set for this session, now first of all we would like to discuss the conceptual framework of Sustainable Developmental Goals. These goals are built on successes of Millennium Developmental Goals that were set in the year 2000, and that has 8 goals pertaining to poverty and hunger, primary education and secondary education, gender equality, reduction in maternal and child mortality, AIDS, tuberculosis and malaria, reversal trends, environmental sustainability and global partnerships. So, successes of MDG provided a platform for development of sustainable developmental goals and for a global commitment for development. Sustainable developmental goals are also known as global goals, because here it is considered a entire globe as a village, as a one unit. They are reframed, structured of MDGs in a comprehensive manner. MDGs primarily considered on security aspects, particularly maternal mortality, child mortality, AIDS, tuberculosis and malaria. But the SDGs has a greater, wider commitment. It is more comprehensive in the sense that it provides, takes care into cognizance the overall development and health of the people of the entire globe. In 2015, World set new 17 goals to end poverty, protect the planet and ensure that all people enjoy peace and prosperity. So, ending poverty, protecting the planet, and ensuring that all people enjoy peace and prosperity. These were the basic framework of SDGs, and the new goals have been set in the year 2015. SDGs are based on certain core principles. SDGs have 5 core principles. Number one is people. It emphasizes as people, not diseased persons only, people as a whole. It emphasizes on the planet security, planet partnerships of various within and outside country, global partnerships. It talks of prosperity, not only disease reduction. And last but not least, global peace. Because unless global peace is achieved, probably global peace, security, and people will not be progressed or not be healthy on psychological or other framework. This SDGs provides a framework to shape policies agenda for next 15 years, that is 2030. New and different about 17 SDGs: universality, that's number one, integration and conversion. So SDGs are basically emphasizing upon 3 aspects. One is integration, are various sectors which are concerned with health, conversion of certain keys in certain areas, and universality. Universality, first and most important, these goals apply to every nation, every sector, every city, businessmen, school, organizations, all that are challenged to act. So, universality, this is called universal. Integration, second, it is recognized that goals are all interconnected in one way or another. So, we cannot aim to achieve just one goal, we must achieve them all. This is called integration. We should not progress a concept on only one goal only. All 17 together will make a difference. And their interconnectedness are also there. So, integration, conversion, and finally, it is widely recognized that achieving these goals involves making a big, very big fundamental changes in how we live on earth. So, we have to have very, very big fundamental changes in our concepts that how we live, and this is called conversion. The goals of, so, having the discussing the conceptual frameworks, let us examine what are the different goals that have been said in sustainable developmental goals. 17 goals of SDGs are, number 1, end poverty in all its forms and everywhere. Number 2, zero hunger, achieve food security and improve nutrition and promote sustainable agriculture. Number 3, ensure healthy lives and promote well-being for all at all ages. This is a very wonderful goal because and directly concerns with the health sector, that promote well-being for each and every people in different from ages, between preschool, school age group, adolescents, adults, and genetic subjects. So we have to take care of from in real sense, it is the provision of the comprehensive health care for people of the world. Ensure inclusive and equitable quality education. The earlier MDG goal emphasized on reversible of the gap between gender gap between primary and secondary education. But SDGs talks of ensuring inclusion and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning for all. Because learning has to be lifelong, because knowledge doubles every 5 years, particularly in the medical sector. And therefore, once a person is self-learner, probably nobody can educate him. Achieving gender equality and empower all women and girls. 6, ensure availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all. In spite of global commitment of safe water supply and sanitation, in many developing countries, it has remained a problem. And so, this is the 6th goal of SDGs emphasizes on ensuring availability and sustainable management. Not only availability, sustainable management is also important, because resources, particularly in terms of water, are depleting. Water for drinking. Ensure access to affordable, reliable, sustainable, modern energy for all. Because energy crisis, energy management, ensuring access to affordable and reliable and sustainable modern energy is a key issue. Promote sustained, inclusive and sustainable economic growth. Inclusive growth, that those who are left out of the from the ambit of economic growth, they should be brought in, and not only they should be partner to the development, they should be equal in utilizing the benefits of that development also. Build resilient infrastructure. Promote inclusive and sustainable industrialization and foster innovations. Because innovations are key to progress. People have to be think in terms of sustainable industrialization, resilient infrastructure, and inclusive growth. Because without these things, development in any country cannot be thought of on long-term basis. tend to reduce inequality within and among countries. Consider India. There is wide state-wise variations. Within the state there are variations. Within district there are variations. Within villages there are inequalities. There are inequalities in among countries. We can't think that all countries will become equal, but at least on the key issues, the inequalities within and among various countries should be taken care of with global partnership. Make cities and human settlements inclusive, resilient, and sustainable. One of the key effects of population rise is on the environment of cities, on the quality of cities, and also on the psychosocial and basic health of the people who are living in urban areas. So urban issues, urban population are rising, the problems are different, and you have to take care of that. Ensure sustainable consumption and protection of power patterns, because unless you do that, probably you cannot think of sustainable development in the future. So sustaining all human resources for future generations, optimizing their efficiency and optimizing their efficiency becomes important. Take urgent actions to combat climate change and its impact. We are taking care of immediate concerns like safe water supply, basic sanitation. But we have to consider other issues like greenhouse effect, climate change, which is changing the epidemiology of diseases occurring in a particular area. Certain areas which were free from certain diseases, they are being exposed to newer diseases, and disease patterns are also changing. So climate change issues, climate becomes important and they require global actions. Target 14 emphasizes on conserving and sustaining use of oceans, seas and marine resources for sustainable development. There are ample opportunities in terms of resources in the oceans, sea and marine, and for sustainable development we can take care of. Say for example, on the area of food and nutrition, maybe we have to switch over from conventional sources of food to non-conventional sources of food. And there are plenty of opportunities for oceans, seas, marine, but one thing that they take into account that while exploiting those resources, the issue of sustainable development must be taken into account. Goal number 15, protect, restore and promote sustainable use of terrestrial ecosystems. Sustainably managed forests combat de-diversification and hard and reserve land degradation and hard biodiversity loss. Biodiversity loss will lead to species in future that may create very significant problem. So from the narrow-centric view of environment, we have to have a very wider applications, wider thinking in terms of preserving our biodiversity. Promote peaceful and inclusive societies, because war, conflicts, injustice, these lead to societies which are not healthy. Even peaceful at family level makes a lot of difference. So we have to promote peaceful and inclusive societies for development, sustainable development. We have to provide access to justice for all and build effective, accountable and inclusive institutions at all levels. So peace, partnership, and global peace, family at individual level, at family level, at societal level is desired. Strengthen the means of implementation and revitalize a global partnership for sustainable development on finances, technology, capacity building, trade, and systematic issues. Once we look at these goals, they also emphasize not only our commitment, they are also, it is not simply agenda, they also identify the key areas of action. The last goal, that is 17th goal, clearly states means of implementation and revitalization the global partnership. For what? For sustainable development on in the area of finance, in the area of technology, capacity building, trade and systematic issues. Now, thus the major categories of goals are number one, SDGs and as extension of MDGs. Second group, inclusiveness, deals with jobs, infrastructure, industrialization and distribution. Third group, sustainability and livelihood, covers sustainable cities and communities, life below water, resources and environment, peace and justice. Sustainable developmental goals in a diagrammatic representation, you can see that no poverty, zero hunger, good health, quality education, water equality, clean water equality, and there are so many globally, the global goals can be handling the government representations are also available. Targets of sustainable development goals. In order to achieve 17 sustainable development goals, 159 targets have been set by United Nations targets. Out of 169 targets, 9 targets were set for health. Difference between, you know, once discussing the various goals, 17 goals that have been set in, difference between MDG and SDG are MDGs were drawn by a group of experts in the United Nations headquarters. Whereas SDG has better participation, wider participation of civil society organizations, thematic and country consultations, participation of global public through face to face meetings and online meetings, and door to door communication. MDG includes a date with 21 targets and 63 indicators, whereas SDG has 17 goals, 159 targets. The MDG goals were primarily focused on diseases, whereas SDG talks about overall development. MDG's source of funding was rich countries only. Here SDGs, it was indicated that all countries, together with SDGs, were expected to work towards achieving SDGs. The SDGs they themselves should be also sustainable, and that requires continued participation in the SDGs. MDGs have two direct objectives, four targets, and 15 indicators to utilize climate, environment, maturity, and community. However, SDGs have one comprehensive goal to utilize well being and healthy living for all at all ages, including prevention of health. So, SDG talks are comprehensive goals in well-being and healthy living at all ages. MDG adopted from baseline data for year 1990 was used. That means it has been traditionally for past years of 2000, and it took data, baseline data of 1990, took 25 years. The baseline will come to 2016 minutes. MDG had no concrete role for civic society organizations. He worked with society actors. Corporate social responsibility organizations play important role in holding governments accountable at local level. MDGs, it heavily focused on social development issues, poverty, health, and education. Whereas SDGs, both social, economic, and environmental. Except goals 7 and 8 addressed developing countries in MDG, whereas SDG talks universal in nature, addressing all developed and developing countries. It talks of energy, it talks of peace, it talks of the partnerships and so on. Major areas addressed in relation to health and nutrition. Issues related to health and nutrition. The third SDG specifically focused to ensure healthy life and promote well-being for all ages and all. Now, if you talk of healthy life, it is the classical definition of World Health Organization that health is a state of complete physical and social well-being and not merely absence of disease or health. Then we are talking about physical health, we are talking about mental health, we are talking about social health. and a new dimension of future as well also being added. So, if you want to ensure that everybody is healthy, not only in physical health, but mental health, but social health, and spiritual dimension, this have a set of things to do, ultimate well-being of all ages. But there are certain areas, earlier the concept of was focusing on the priority groups. But we have realized that all age groups, the health is a continuum from child to old age. And therefore, these all ages should be given equal importance, and we should have a lot of people so that things can be taken care of in a better way. Our social determinants of health is to go through the system. Social determinants of health has been, although they are widely talked on, but they require more emphasis, because it is not important that we are just addressing the diseases. We have to stop or we have to curb those processes which are leading to ill health in people, whether it is communicable disease, non-communicable disease, behavioral disease, or professional disease. To ensure healthy life, we need 9 targets and post a group called points of engagement. Health targets are: reduce the global maternal mortality rate to below 70 per 100,000 live births. Number 2, reduce the neonatal mortality rate to below 12 1,000 and infant mortality rate below 25 per 1,000 live births. In the epidemics of AIDS, tuberculosis, malaria, and neglected tropical diseases, other communicable diseases, this is a very important area, because there are certain diseases which are confined to certain geographical zones, where neglected tropical diseases and other communicable diseases. Reduce by 1/3 premature mortality from non-communicable diseases. Non-communicable diseases are important to potential threats. These are the Indian data then, 0.3% of mortality is now accountable to non-communicable diseases. So, what is important that premature mortality from non-communicable diseases has to be taken care of. And the goal is to reduce 1/3 premature mortality rate from non-communicable diseases. Now, non-communicable diseases, diabetes, hypertension, cancer, they are important. And in fact, India is facing double burden of disease, communicable and non-communicable diseases. And there is another, that behavioral diseases are playing very significant. So, we have to strengthen the preventive and treatment of substance abuse. Whether it's food, tobacco consumption, alcohol consumption, or it is very important and very important concerns in public health. Because unless we take care of tobacco menace, unless we take care of alcohol menace, unless we take care of drug consumption, particularly in urban areas, probably that we can't ensure mental health, probably we can't help or change the pattern of emerging threat of non-communicable diseases. Of the number of global deaths and injuries from road traffic accidents, this is important because road traffic accidents are becoming very serious because of an increasing number of vehicles, and alcohol consumption is also increasing. Great play to the increase in global deaths and injuries from road traffic accidents. Come out. Road safety issues need to be applied for. And both, not only legislative process, regulatory process, but also people need to be educated about this risk. People should be also made aware that what are the services available for victims of road traffic accidents, and the factors that lead to that. Seventh point is ensure universal access to sexual reproductive care. Universal accessibility to sexual reproductive health care is key, because that will ensure 50% that take care of 50% of the population, and particularly the reproductive age, because this is leading to low child and kids are doing without them. Life of the sexual gender ratio at birth. Achieve universal health coverage. That is a general commitment by various governments. Universal health coverage means the provision of health services to a part of the entire. The purpose is to reduce out of pocket expenses. Because many people, 50% of the population, live below poverty line every year just to maintain their cost of living. So, universal health coverage that requires a huge financial impact. But you can decide that a minimum entitlements, health entitlements, and you can all the little money so that most of these conditions be for the people of the world. Due to the number of deaths and risks of hazardous chemicals and air, water, soil, and so on. Four sub-points for health are strengthening and implementing the WHO framework of pollution and tobacco control. Tobacco manage very hard. Tobacco can lead to any type of problem. So, this is the commitment in the implementation process of WHO Support the research and development of vaccines and medicines that has to come. The practice of today has evolved from theory of study. And we have to be more research oriented, particularly the operating process part, and also vaccines and medicines. We have vaccines and medicines to meet the core challenges of the resistance and so on. Considering increased health financing, recruitment, development, training, and retention of the health workers. Not only we have to develop health financing component, but we have to take care of our recruitment, development, and training policy, and particularly retention of the workforce in the system. And that requires a very congenial environment, working environment, and financial training. Extending early warning risk reduction in medicine. Early warning system, risk reduction approach, exercising your primordial beliefs, and management of risks are two areas of action for unconscious people who are healthy and productive. And some nutrition targets have been also fixed. Personal development goals to target in poverty. Particularly hunger by 2030 in all forms of malnutrition, including achieving 2025. The international aid targets are 2025. We should not forget that although still we are talking about reduction in undernutrition, but overnutrition, obesity, diabetes, and particularly going to be a major threat in the coming years, and therefore nutrition targets, although we have to look into that part, but maybe looking into other things. Now, just to summarize the whole thing, what has happened, we had success in MDG. MDG provided material and environmental goals, and by 2015 provided a platform. Somewhere, the CD was wrong. The CD is frequently cognizant that we have to talk in terms of provision of health and well-being, and not only having behavioral issues. This SDGs differ significantly from MDG in one way, like global involvement, and development of the. Contrary to the MDG, that this was really targeting them. Targets, no 59 targets. But we have to prepare a road map for achieving various goals set in SDGs, and we have to ensure midterm monitoring processes of our success in that way. There is a greater commitment, global commitment, and there is also need for integration of all the departments, all the sectors, all the countries in ensuring sustainable development globally. Because in health, nothing is as universal as health has no boundaries. Because of simply trade, simply might travel one beach and travel from one area to another area. And so, therefore, we have to talk in terms of sustainable development globally. Thank you very much for listening to me.